The five most important words, you did a good job. The four most important words, what's your opinion? The three important words, if you please. Two important words, thank you. One important word, we. Least important, I. Today, we're going to talk in a little bit here about some foods to avoid. Now, we have many, many choices in front of us. And Victoria Bochenko recalled that when she came to the United States with her family, they went to the grocery store and they were amazed at the choices of foods that were available that they could not find in Russia. And she said, I literally wanted to try everything in the grocery store because there were all those choices. And she literally tried many things, and her daughter had came down with asthma, her son came down with diabetes. She gained maybe a considerable weight, not exactly how much, and her husband became very sick and had several surgeries and needed more medical assistance. And when she began to heal herself and she came to the Creative Health Institute, she was there for 9 months, she was able to heal herself by avoiding going to the grocery store and living on organic fruit, organic vegetables, and making juices, green drinks, green smoothies. And she is the person who's responsible for coming up with a green smoothie. Other people may have done it, but she was promoting, wrote a book about the green smoothie, and did research on it. And what she has come up with, and I wrote a book called 10 Foods to Avoid, and one of the first foods to avoid is white flour. White flour is glue. You know that wallpaper paste is flour? When my mother and father were wallpapering the living room, we used gold metal flour and water and made paste and put up a wallpaper and it stuck. So if we're putting that white flour into us, what are we doing? We're gumming up our intestines all the way down. And it sticks, and some of it stays there and coats the inside and blocks the absorption of food. So we've coated the insides of our intestinal system with white paste. Well, if the paste isn't enough, the next thing we do, we add glue. Many people are eating and drinking Elmer's glue every day. School children are having the main ingredient in Elmer's glue for lunch. Well, what is that? What's Elmer's glue made of? And what color Elmer's glue is?
White.
It's
milk.
White. It's milk. Okay. Elmer's glue is made from milk. And what's in the milk is protein, and we think, oh, it's got protein in it. That's great. No, it isn't. The protein in milk is not the same as vegetable protein. It's not meat protein. It's a very unique protein, and it's called casein, C-A-S-I-E-N, casein. And that is the really tough glue that is used to glue things together. So we're putting in paste in our bodies, then we're adding glue. And why are people quite constipated? Why are people getting sick? The food that you're eating does not get absorbed because the intestinal tract is lined with paste and glue. And the research in the China study, a 20-year longitudinal study in 63 counties, 20 years, kept track of what people ate, did blood tests, and Oxford University did the analysis of the data, and they found out who got breast cancer, who got liver cancer, who got prostate cancer, and different diseases, and they were able to correlate those clusters, and then they went back and they found out they ate. We couldn't do that study on the American population. The approximately 93% of the American population is eating processed food, and they are part of the Chinese population. We had people who were not sick, who are not eating processed food, who are not drinking cow's milk, who are not eating white bread, white rice maybe, but they had a vegetable diet and were not eating the food. And the study on the NERSA study, which is a Springington study, and all these studies, many of the